The four most popular retinols we're going to be discussing in this video, the one from the Pilgrim, the one from the Minimalist, both the older one and the new one, and comparing the older one with the Earth Rhythm and discussing the new Earth Rhythm Retinol Serum. Retinoids are one ingredient which you could use extremely long term for decades together because they really just build the skin from the inside out. To quickly summarize what retinoids do for you, have a look at this. I have a huge playlist of retinoids. Please do have a look. This is a little advanced video, so I'm just going to be discussing the four products. The first product I want to discuss is the one from the Pilgrim. This retinol comes with two vitamin C. So it has sodium ascorbate, sodium ascorbyl phosphate, which means that along with retinoid, you also have the support of vitamin C to build your collagen, give you fading, and to fight oxidative stress. Oxidative stress, if you don't know, is the balance that is required for a body because the amount of free radicals in the atmosphere. The best way for me to put it is to get your attention on how important it is to fight oxidative stress is to tell you that the free radicals around you can actually fry and kill your collagen. And when the collagen breaks down, you get massive wrinkles, you get hyperpigmentation. Basically, it just makes the skin weak and it's not able to fight, it's not strong enough. So make sure that you're protecting yourself against free radicals. So this particular serum gives you the double benefit of vitamin C and retinoid. Along with that, it also has sodium benzoate, which means that this particular retinol is very, very safe if you have fungal acne, which is a question I get very, very often. So good over there. It also has fantastic soothers and hydrators. It's got almond, it's called maltodextrin, which is a very good humectant. It's got sodium hyaluronate, it's got vitamin E. Then it has sodium gluconate, and it also has sugarcane extract. It has a few more star ingredients. It's got anti-inflammatory extracts from various fruits, and it also has rose in it. Rose extract also is very, very anti-inflammatory and very soothing to the skin. That is why rosehip oil is so popular. And along with all the fading packed in from the vitamin C and the retinol, it also has fading help from niacinamide, from cranberry and bearberry. What do cranberry and bearberry have? Cranberry and bearberry is where alpha-arbutin is extracted from. And so you have fading help from alpha-arbutin also. So fantastic fading help, fantastic moisturization, fantastic humectants, and of course the retinol. But when I asked them for the percentage of retinol in the customer care, they said, we can't tell you what the percentage is. I'm like, what? Because guys, I have a thing about customer care. If I'm buying something, I need to know what it is I'm buying. The fact that it's a trust barrier. I'm leaving my skin to your product for 6 months. I should know what I'm putting on my face. So then I cancel this order and that's it. Moving on. The Minimalist, this particular retinol from Minimalist is at 0.03%. It's got bakuchiol and it's got Q10 enzyme. It's got fantastic soothers and hydrators. It's got squalane, which is very good at moisturizing, as well as, you know, an anti-inflammatory, again, vitamin E. Along with that, it also has caprylic and capric triglyceride, which is great antioxidants. Antioxidants fight free radical damage, which is what we want all the time. Along with that, it has cocoa or caprate, which is a great emollient. So very good support from emollient base as well as hydration base. And of course, it's got bakuchiol. Bakuchiol is one of those ingredients which is really enjoying its time under the sun. Everybody loves it because it's supposed to be as close to retinol in all its quality. So it's supposed to help you fade, supposed to control acne, supposed to control acne scars, supposed to be anti-aging, supposed to improve the health of your cell, all the goodness. It's packed in over there. Then it has Q10 enzyme. Q10 enzyme is an enzyme which not only helps your skin to hydrate and moisturize better, but it also does this magical thing of building your collagen and fighting oxidative stress. Very, very important to make sure that there are enough ingredients in your products that are going to fight oxidative stress, especially for us in India. In India, the environmental pollution is very high, guys. Nothing to joke about. So Q10 gives you all of that. Collagen makes your skin really, really strong. Now let's move on to the third retinol that we're going to be talking about, which is the retinol from Earth Rhythm. This is a new release and it has HBR 2%. It has got fantastic soothers and hydrators. It's got glycerine, vitamin E. It again has caprylic and capric triglyceride, which the one from the Minimalist has. Then it's got caprate, which again the Minimalist has, which is a fantastic emollient. It also has butyline, glycol and squalene, great hydrators and great soothing agents for your skin. The HPR is pegged against retinoin and supposed to be as good at it, but it does not have the science, does not have the time, you know, the data set collected over decades to tell you that yes, it is as good or as great a gold standard in skincare and anti-aging as retinoin has. So it starts with that little bit of a disadvantage. The second thing is that HPR at 2% in the formulation will still give you 0.2%, not a full 2%, because HPR has to be diluted 1:10 when it's used in formulation and is generally diluted with isosorbide. So you're not getting 2%, which throws people off and they believe, oh, that's a very high percentage of retinol. It is not. It is at 0.2%. Now, when we compare this with the one from the Minimalist, which is again HPR 2%, these products are almost identical. You know, they have used different ingredients, but they're similar in terms of how much, you know, humectant support it has, how much soothing support it has, and what are the other actives. So, koi jyada farak nahi, is almost the same. Here are my parting thoughts on the retinoids. The Minimalist released the first retinoid with a dropper. The dropper didn't work. The product sanctity wasn't there. Now they've gone back and changed it into an air pump. So Minimalists, please don't send haters down in my comment section. But here is my grouse, that agar aap ek hi packaging change kar rahe hain, there's somebody in the company who knows that this retinoid is best shared as an airless pump bottle. So why not do it the same for the Q10 retinoid? Why just are you doing it only for the 2%? And that would bring you to the point of this. I bought this from the Minimalist when it was launched. I tried to use it a couple of times. This is the batch where the droppers never worked. So try as you might, it doesn't work. And then the whole bottle kind of emulsified. So there is product inside, but it doesn't come out unless you fight with it, right? The question is, what is the integrity of the product then, right? And so, I stopped using this product. Now, did this product stop working because of the air? I don't know. But the moment the product changes its consistency, there is deterioration that's happened. It is not as it's supposed to be. So therefore, kuch to change hua hai emulsion mein, right? So I stopped using it. For their new launch of retinoid, I'm not going to be buying it because the packaging is still the same. And you know, boon boon se ocean bharta hai. I can't be spending 600-700 rupees one time at a time, and considering I have so many other products to review. So I'm not going to be using the other retinoid also. These retinol serums are fairly easy to use into your skincare. The ones from Earth Rhythm and the Minimalist with HPR 2% are fairly mild serums, because even though HPR is at the same level as retinoin, it does not have the same irritation and the redness and the retinization process that you would undergo if you are doing a tretinoic acid, right? Though, however, HPR doesn't have the same time set. You see, tretinoin has been used for decades and decades. So there's a lot of rich data sets to say that it really does reverse aging. HPR doesn't have that. But if you wanted to start using retinol, then it's a good place to start with. The new release from the Minimalist at 0.3% is a fairly strong retinol serum. This serum is actually the same formulation that Paula's Choice has. Paula's Choice has the same 0.3% retinol serum with bicochiol, and I think it also has Q10, I'm not sure. I have used the retinol in the past from Paula's Choice, but right now I'm using Retin A at 0.5%, so which is really the highest grade that you will get over the counter in India. And clearly the difference between the two is dramatic. Because the serum is still gentle, because remember, retinol is two steps removed from tretinoin. All the esters of vitamin A have to convert for them to give you the same benefit as the tretinoin does when it's put on the skin. With all of these serums, it's incredibly important that you make sure your sunscreen game is on and you're religious about using sunscreen, because these do affect our sensitivity to UV radiation. If you are somebody who has been using retinol serums and want to up your game a little bit, you could give the Minimalist a try. Are you going to see a dramatic difference? you know, it's too early to say. The real test for these serums, whether they really make a difference to your skin and give you anti-aging benefit, is to be having used them for at least 2 years, which means in a year you will at least use 6 bottles. And that's 12 bottles in 2 years. And that is 600 rupees into 12 bottles. Whereas you could just use Retin A at 400 rupees and the tube lasts you for a year, 3 months. Choice is yours. And my this thing is ki agar aap itna time de rahe ho to just graduate to a Retin A, start from 0.25% and then graduate to 0.5% because that is tretinoic acid, which is like the gold standard, right? So since packaging plays such a big role in keeping the retinol effective for a longer period of time, here is what my thoughts are. Pilgrim is completely out of the way because the wide open mouth jar may not keep the product effective for too long. There's just too much air entering the jar at one time, so we don't even know how long it's going to be effective for. Is the effectiveness going to, you know, be neutralized in 1 month, 2 months, 3 months? Nobody knows. And you don't want to be pressurized to using a product in a limited period of time just because it's going to lose its effectiveness, right? So I can't recommend Pilgrim. With the Minimalist, I really wish, since they've already changed the 2% retinoid into an airless pump bottle, they could have just as easily done it for the 0.3% retinol with bakuchiol and Q10. It's just a matter of packaging, because we know for a fact that packaging does improve the effectiveness and the shelf life of a retinoid serum. The Earth Rhythm though comes on top of it, because one, it has got an airless pump, which is what we want from a retinol serum. And also, you know, if you're somebody who's going to be using the retinol on a very limited basis, say once a week, you have enough actives or other face serums that you want to combine in your skincare, and you don't want to be pressurized to using your retinol jabardasti, you know, 3 to 4 times a week because it might lose its effectiveness or because of other choices, then it's a great buy. Though at $17.50, it is a little expensive. I can't justify the packaging, especially with the ingredients, because the ingredients are very similar to the Minimalist 2%. And Minimalist has been able to give the same HPR in an airless pump for almost half the cost. Difficult to justify $17.50, but if you're an Earth Rhythm fan, then you're an Earth Rhythm fan. So I do not like to spend money on the retinoid serums. I mean, I can get it from my Retin A cream, which is for $400, and it lasts me for a year and a half, right? I'm going to meet you in the comment section and continue the discussion there.